Here we go. Let's ride.
Hey girls, welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes. I'm JB. Boy, crawfish prices, I guess because of the big flood we have had, are just rock bottom right now. They're at 97 cents a pound per sack, which is, and I hadn't seen them that cheap in quite some time. We'll talk about how to boil them in a minute. First, let me tell y'all a true story about when I was just a kid growing up. I must have been around 5-6 years old. And on Easter Sunday, my grandpa, my uncle, my dad, and a couple cousins, we'd all go out in the spillway and catch crawfish. And on our way down, we would stop and get the what they use to bait the nets with. And I'll show you a net in just a second. And it was called beef smelt, I think, which I believe is from the spleen of the cow. And it was real cheap, like 10 cents a pound. And you would take it and cut it into strips. And the net, it was a square-based net, and it had a little string in the middle that you would tie your bait onto. And here's a kind of a picture, I don't know if y'all be able to see it well, of a net and a Cajun in the swamp. And that's the net right there. And it had some wires that came up, some heavy-gauge wires that came up to a point. They were twisted together, and there's a little flag on top. You really can't see them in this photo, but there's a little orange flag on top so you can find your nets easily. And you would push around a little wash tub like that and dump the nets into it. And you had to use a stick to lift the net, because sometimes there may be a snake in that net. You had to shoo him off. Or run like hell yourself if you was a kid and didn't like snakes too much. We'll crawfish in shallow areas, usually about knee-deep water, something like that, or a little less because those wires, they're about that tall, and you got to be able to see the top of that net to know where it's at. Not a commercial crawfisherman use a big net or trap, and they actually tie a float onto it. And they go out and with a boat and empty their nets and rebait them and carry on. But my Uncle Joe, the clumsiest Cajun alive, and Uncle Joe, he could be sitting in a chair and get up and fall, trip on his own 2 feet. So we'd always go down there and we would take 2 batteaux. One batteau with a motor and one just to pull to put the crawfish in. You'd buy sacks, empty sacks, at the sport goods supply store where you bought your nets. And between about 8 of us, we could get in about 3-4 hours in the swamp working the traps and the nets. We can get 10 sacks of crawfish easy. And for $10 in for the nets and the smelt, the bait, plus the fuel for the boat, man, you come home, have a big old crawfish boil. Well, Grandma and Mom would always pack us some sandwiches, and back then they didn't have Ziplocs. They had those fold and seal kind of bags, you know, glad bags, whatever you want to call them. She'd put the sandwiches in there and some chips and things like that. And we'd go out, and Uncle Joe, every time we'd go and launch the boat and we got it by the dock, and Uncle Joe, "I've got the sandwiches." And my grandpa, "No!" Splash! Uncle Joe fell off the dock into the water. And in the bayou, now the sandwiches are all wet. Damn it, boy. So, yeah, we'd get out there and be working the traps and everything and catching crawfish, and you'd hear splash. Jonah tripped in the swamp, fell underwater. Oh, yeah. But you would stay in the shallow areas where the water was running out the swamps, because that's where they like to go, the crawfish. They like that clean rainwater, that swamp water. And they don't like stagnant water. And they don't like salt water either. That's why they say never purge your crawfish with salt, because it'd kill them. And you may lose half of your sack if you let them sit in that salt water too long. Fresh water, yeah. They can take that, and they like it oxygenated, which is the proper way to peel them, according to the Louisiana Department of Agriculture and Fisheries and all that. Not peel them, purge them, is put them in a tank with fresh water and oxygen, put aerators in it, and let them sit in that for 24 hours, and it purges their system out. That's the proper way to do it. Anyway, yeah, with the common occurrence, he'd normally fall. Joe would fall several times, and sometimes he'd be carrying his bucket of crawfish, a wash tub of crawfish, splash, and lost all the crawfish he had. Damn it, boy. I also remember we used to have to help Uncle Joe get in the boat, because he'd flip the boat over. And Joe either get in on the front or the back. Don't get in on the side. He had that boat tipped over like that. Splash again. Now everybody wet and mad at Uncle Joe. Who are you, Joe? But anyway, how do you boil crawfish? It's in the old days, okay. All we had was these sacks. It's a little, let me open it up. Open. Okay, it's a little porous sack with a bunch of seeds. Boy, it smells good too. And what's in it? All right. The ingredients are mustard seed, coriander seed, red pepper flakes, bay leaves, dill seed, clove, and allspice. There's no salt in it, no garlic in it, no onion. So what we would do, no pepper, other than a little bit of red pepper flakes that's in here. Guess you can see that, okay? So what we would do, it'd be add extra cayenne to the boiling pots and some liquid crab ball. They had that back then, along with lemons, garlic, onion, and salt. You know, we would buy regular size things of salt, cut the tops off and dump them in the, you know, for a sack of crawfish you may need, I don't know, about, depends on your taste, how much your salt tolerance is, and how much red pepper you like, how hot do you like them. I said lemons, yeah. And if lemons weren't available, we use that real lemon juice. Today, they sell these prepackaged, this is Louisiana Fish Fry brand of crawfish, crab, and shrimp mix. It's got the salt, the red pepper, dried garlic in it, dried onion, and some of them have lemon flavor too. I don't think this one does. Today we'll use this plus with that other stuff I showed you. Some people like to add to their burling pot, along with the potatoes and the corn, that got to be in there. Let me mention too, they got instructions on the back of these bags. This is a small one. I think this one will only do up to about 15 pounds of crawfish, this whole bag. But they got big ones that'll do a whole sack size, is what it's called. They do a whole sack. And then we add lanyap, like extra garlic, extra lemons, some more of that liquid crab ball. You don't put no more salt. They got plenty of that in there. But a lot of people like to add celery, artichokes. Oh, sausage got to go in there too. Some good smoked sausage, put that in there in that boiling water. We normally put the potatoes in as soon as the pot starts coming up to the boil, because they take the longest. We use the little B-size potatoes. And then when it's finally up to the boil, we put the onions, the garlic, the lemons, all the seasonings, along with the crawfish, the whole sack. And after they boil, after it's come back to a boil, full rolling boil, for 5 minutes, you shut the fire off and cool the pot down quick as you can. You can use the frozen corn ears, the little half ears, and put them in there to help cool your pot down. But you want to get your pot down about 160. And so we dump some ice in it. Dump about 10 pounds of ice in a, say, an 80-quart pot to cool it down. 10 pounds, that's about 8 pounds. And let them sit there and steep. You steep them for at least 20 minutes. You let it go 30 minutes, they'll suck up even more of that spice. They'll be hotter, saltier, in other words. And sit down and eat. We don't bother to peel the garlic, because after this is cooked, you can just take the whole thing and squeeze it in your mouth. Talk about good on bread, good on the potatoes. And the onions, if you try to cut them in half, the insides are gonna come out and it's just gonna be nothingness. You ain't gonna hardly have. Whereas those, the boiled onions, the skin's gonna come off the outside and you can just eat it like that. And it tastes delicious in that boiling liqueur or water. When you're done, you can take that water and use it as a tree killer, a weed killer around your property. Just don't put it close to your house, because it's going to smell like dead seafood, or, you know, after you're done. So you put it around a perimeter of your fence or something like that. And all the salt in it is what it is. It's the salt and the cayenne. It's going to kill your weeds. And it'll kill a tree, too. So don't put it close to your shade trees. Let me take a break. One bag does 4 pounds of crawfish, shrimp, or a dozen crabs. There you go. I may have not mentioned that this season oil wasn't always available. This boil mix. But these sacks were. Now this brand here wasn't established until 1982. But the Rex brand, now this isn't their sack, but this is one of their seasonings, was established in 1888. Let me add another little item in here. We also used to cook our crawfish over a wood fire, build a wood fire outside, and we had a stand made out of rebar to put our big boiling pot on. That's how we used to do it. Cool, huh? You didn't turn the fire off. You had to move the pot off the fire, and you had to have like some welding gloves to do so, and two strong guys, because a pot full of that much water with crawfish in it is heavy and hot. I'll show y'all some photos of some crawfish balls that we've had in the past. Do keep them out of the sun, cool and wet. Purge them in fresh water. Drain them. Do that several times. You can have crawfish races and find a big boy and put your hand up in there. They won't bite, I promise. See, you got to prep all that stuff up. Without help, there's no way that one person can pull this off on a large scale. And I do appreciate everybody that helped out here. There they are chilling and steeping, and they done sucked up that liquid, so that pot's heavy now. Plus all the other stuff that's in the pot weighs more. You spread them out, and it's time to eat. You don't want none of them to hit that flow. Yum. Nothing but yum. Them garlics just jump in my mouth. I'll eat almost all of them that nobody else wants.
We'll be fighting over them. Cauliflower rocks. As piggery in action. And Rudolph Foods always send us a couple cases of products. Pig skins. Pork rinds. And we have muffalatas. We get those out. And hog head cheese. Yum. Pickled quail eggs. Yum. These rock right here. Boudin balls from, they sell them everywhere. And smoked boudin. Sometimes I'll go ahead and make some hot Cajun burl peanuts. And we normally have some couple other sides, like Lynn'll make some jambalaya. And his darling wife, Becky, which is my wife's sister, will make some navy beans. And we got all kind of desserts. I mean, look, there's bread banana pudding and bread puddings and cheesecakes and just all kind of stuff. After we fill us a tick, we'll go up in there and have a little jam with the ones that are musicians. And we'll have multiple musicians there. We'll be swapping. This one will play, that one will play, and we'll all play around. And like I said, it really couldn't be done without family and friends helping out. And I really do appreciate all of them who've came and helped out. Because, like I say, without them, there's no way that I could pull off anything like this. And it's a lot of fun. And getting together with everybody and just having a good time. And there's many people that's came. And I'm really, you know, kind of showing the ones who've helped out, you know, help me put it together and do some of the cooking and prep work, because they're all great folks. And most of these, matter of fact, all of them are from YouTube. That's where I met all of them. And just a great bunch of folks. And Booger and Tom are just so nice people. They'll sit down and peel me the leftover crawfish. And look, I gave her a big kiss, and I think Lyndon pinched her. So we'll make some crawfish remoulade and crawfish etouffee the next day and feed everybody that's still hanging around. Yum, boy. Au revoir. Le bouton roulé, chef. Ouais, a boy.